there, everybody, and welcome back to me doing way too many takes for the opening voiceover comments. Today, we're going to be making mochi ice cream, a little ball of ice cream wrapped safely in a mochi carrying package. Also, to silence any rumors, no, I did not record the ice cream making part 6 days ago on Thursday, and no, I did not lose the footage, so quit it. The ice cream part, we're going to need 8 fluid ounces of heavy whipping cream, 7 fluid ounces of sweetened condensed milk, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1/8 to 1/4 teaspoons of kosher salt, and 2 ounces of clotted cream. Acceptable substitute is 1 ounce of mascarpone cheese diluted with 2 ounces of heavy whipped cream. Just mix them together. And as always, the ingredients are available in the description below. Now we're going to put everything, so the heavy cream, the condensed milk, the vanilla, the kosher salt, and come on, get out of there. Come on. There we go. Everything to a medium-sized bowl. Then we're going to be whipping it for 6 minutes or so until it reaches stiff picks with a hand mixer or a stand mixer. This took me 6 minutes. It may vary. Now put all that stuff inside of a bowl. Make sure that bowl has a top onto it, or if not, do the answer to all the life's problems. Plastic wrap, insert it firmly on the top. It should look like this when you plop it down. Call upon your inner cake decorator and smooth out the tops all nice and pretty like this, and place a top onto it. Put it in a freezer for 4 hours. Quick pro tip, you can put any type of flavoring you want and place the vanilla extract inside of your ice cream. You can use matcha, chocolate, literally anything. Also put some smashed candy canes or chopped chocolate inside if you wish. Now even though it stayed in the freezer for 13 hours, that's 9 hours too long, it was still ultra creamy and smooth. Like, watch this. Yeah. So I don't want to overdo it here, but I can theorize that this can stay frozen for a super long time and still be great. Anyway, I have a small-sized ice cream scoop that I use to scoop it into little cupcake tins. I'm aiming for about 12 mochi in total here. Here, let me show you my perfected method. First, you take a little hunk of the ice cream in there, you smooth it up against the side of the bowl so it's flat on the bottom, and you can chunk it right into your mold. Remember to work quickly, because the thing about ice cream is that it melts. Shocker. Another little trick you can use to make little ice cream balls: take a big spoon and put a bunch of ice cream inside of it. Then put it inside of the scoop and chunk it in. Now in the end, you should have a bunch of flat bottom round top little ice cream flavored things inside of a cupcake tin by now. Here's me 30 minutes later realizing I did not cover it with plastic wrap, so do that. Now put it in the freezer again for, let's say, 2 hours. Why not? Let's do that. 2 hours later, we can start making our mochi. We're going to need 50 grams of granulated sugar, 100 grams of mochiko flour, and 3/4 of a cup of water. Not to mention a bunch of tapioca flour. In a large bowl, we're going to add in the mochiko flour and sugar. Then we're going to take a little whisk, and just kidding, big whisk time, throw it away! And whisk it until homogeneous. Now put your water in and mix it with your spatula until there's no clumps or lumps remaining. Scrape down the sides and cover it in plastic wrap, then put it in the microwave for 1 minute. After that woman is done, lift up the plastic wrap just a little bit and mix it with a wetted rubber spatula to make sure it's cooking evenly. Then do it again. 1 minute, lift up the plastic wrap, rubber spatula, wetted, drill. Then do it one more time with a total of 3 microwaves, and at the end you should have this soft, translucent mochi dough. Look at that, it's beautiful. Now, I'm not gonna lie, this took me a few tries, so here's the try that I did it correctly. Put all your mochi onto a parchment paper lined with a bunch of tapioca flour, more so you can't see the bottom of the parchment paper. Put some of the flour on a rolling pin and put some on the top of the dough, and then you're gonna roll it out to a 12 by 16 inch rectangle on the parchment paper. Now, when you're done spreading it out, carefully take the parchment paper up and put it on top of a baking sheet, whatever. Then put it in the fridge for about 30 minutes. During that time, you can do the editing and voiceover for this section of the video. When the 30 minutes is up, it's time to do the thing I hate most. Effort. Cut out 4-inch circles with a pastry cutter out of your mochi and leave it to the side. Take one of them, brush it off with a pastry brush to get all of that flour off. Take a little ball of ice cream, put it in the center, and fold it around in the knuckle of your hand like this. Then wrap it in plastic wrap very securely. Now, was this hard? Yes. Did I do it perfectly? No. Do I care? Yes. Pro tip! Leave it in the fridge for 1 hour before snacking upon, and roll out your scraps. The scraps from the little mochi circles, roll those out again. I got 2 more that way. Also, leave no air pockets showing inside. For me, it took 3 hours to finally get it out, but we're here anyway, and we're placing it out of the plastic wrap, cutting it in half, and showing it to the camera. Here's on-screen Evan for more details.
So we're in 10 videos, and I just have to say it's been really, it's been fun so far, and I'm gonna turn this into like a little birthday cake for 10, but I don't have candles, at least I can't find them, so we're doing this. Happy 10 videos to me, happy 10. It's not burned on the bottom yet. Aha! No way. That tastes better.
Hey everybody, Evan here. Thank you so much for 10 videos. Thank you so much for watching them. Thank you for putting up with me burning ice cream. See you at 100!